current state of the office. It doesn't look that bad from this angle, but once I go in, ta-da, look at the mess. If my mom was watching this, she would say we're living in a pigsty. So basically the office has kind of become a dumping ground for like the furnitures that we have moved out from other rooms that we did the makeover of, such as like this shelf that came from the entryway and the old bedside table from the bedroom. So this is gonna be sold. I think that one's gonna go in the basement. And then Pat bought this grill, but the outdoor table hasn't arrived yet, so that's why the grill is just sitting there. But it's gonna go out for sure, and all the grill accessories on top as well. Those are some recyclables. Yeah, so basically this part just needs to be decluttered and organized. So the one important thing for the office is that Pat has his bike. I forgot what that thing is called, the Tech X thing. Basically it's this like virtual bike riding thing that he does regularly, so his bike definitely needs to be there. But I think I'm gonna like turn it, rotate it so that it takes up less space over there, and then our desks is gonna shift all the way to the end, so there's some like empty space there for the bike.
Woohoo! That took way too long! So the legs go there?
Yes. Oh, I'm crushing my fingers again.
You did not learn. Telescope, take me on this journey home.
So we finished building the drawer unit and also those legs over there. These two were like the easiest IKEA builds that I've ever done. And then we also oiled the countertops and the ivar and left it overnight to dry. And this morning what we did was we installed the monitors. So Pat has these cool monitor stands that allows you to shift the angle of the monitors. And he has been setting up the computers and the server. He has his own server for the whole smart home system. Those are stuff that I'm not good at, so I'm very thankful that he's here to do it. Today, what I want to focus on is to make something for this wall over here. So it's gonna be something pretty big that covers like 70% of the wall width-wise. Yeah, so I'm excited to see how it will turn out, but also nervous because I've never really made something so big before.
Oops.
beginning. Welcome to the new office space. I'm really glad that it's done, and now I'm gonna give you a tour. So our office space is pretty unique, at least compared to the other office spaces that I've seen on YouTube, whereby we have two people with very different needs sharing the same space. So his desk setup is more like a typical office. So he has two monitors, keyboard, mouse, and all that. My desk setup is slightly more colorful, and I have like my art supplies, just a few, like my pencils, a few of the color pencils that I like to sketch with. And currently I'm very into using Posca markers. And over here I have an artwork that I did recently and I really liked it. In the middle we have all our plants and my little doggy. She reminds me of my family dog back home. She looks exactly like that, and I miss her. And below we have these drawers, which are actually really good storage space. So I just have like the stationery that I use the most often, and things like my notepad, my stickers, some camera stuff, cables, thumb drives, memory cards. And then on this side I just have my computer and a small little fake plant just to hide the computer a little or just make it look a bit cuter. On this wall we have the pegboard that I made and painted. I think it will become more functional when I use this space more and figure out what I want on there. Pat said the artwork is very inspirational, which makes me very happy. It's just a nice addition of color to the space. And up there we have all our upper cabinets, which provides really good storage space, like hidden storage space. So we have put like memories, bigger books, some folders. There is one open cubicle where I have just put like my cameras, some of our books, and my little pet collection. I really like Phineas and Ferb, and I don't watch Star Wars, but I've always liked the stormtrooper design. Then below is where we store our printer, some art supplies, some DIY supplies. So on top here, I just have my Cricut that I got as a Christmas present from Pat. I haven't actually yet used it because there was just no like decent clean space for me to use in the previous office, so I was really turned off and didn't feel like using it, but now I'll definitely try it out. We have some of these bins. For now we have like tape, paintbrushes, my label maker, and my paint palette, and these are like receipts and a bit more tape. Now here's where I store my paper products. Like I have a lot of my favorite postcards, letters, stickers, paper bags, and my cutting mat down there. And then these are some illustration and notebooks. This is like my favorite part of the room, because it's where we can hide all our art and DIY stuff. Like here, I have all my stationery that I don't use that often. Camera gear and Polaroid film. And this is like the miscellaneous drawer. Oops. Like I have, what the hell is that called? Like I recently used these to make some macrame for our bedroom curtains, and then some extra folders I have here. Over on this side, I found these retro boxes. They're so cute. So I have like them on display. I don't know what to put in that one yet, but this one has all my acrylic paints, and this jar holds my paintbrushes, and we have a little cute little garden here. That one's a fake plant because I just can't find a pothos plant. Somehow the garden store always sells out of pothos plant, I guess because it's very popular. So currently I have a fake one from IKEA to substitute until I can get my hand on a real pothos. And this is a neon philodendron. And then my little Bulbasaur pot with a gasteria. And we have some little self-watering sprouts. I'm not sure what this one is, but that one's a strawberry plant. And it just sprouted like a day ago. So cute. And then down here we have a printer, a board with my favorite quote. And then the penguin over there has like the whiteboard markers. We have another plant there. In these drawers, we have our DIY tools, like the drill, more tools like the screwdriver, glue, hammer, blah, blah, blah. And the smaller stuff like the screws, gloves, all these bits and bobs. It's really nice that everything like fits in these three drawers because they have just been living like in every space of our house that we can find. So we always like can't find the screwdriver or we can't find the hammer because they're always in different places. And now they're all packed in these three drawers, which is really nice. In the last corner of the room, Pat wanted a giant whiteboard and I wanted to spray paint it gold actually, but then he really wanted it to be black. And he's the primary one who's going to be using it, so I just spray painted it black and I think he has better taste than me because it looks really good. I really like how I can hang these bins on the ivar. These are like the bins for the kitchen drawers, but they hang perfectly here. So here we have like some whiteboard stuff, like this is the whiteboard eraser, his knock. Yep, and his bike. It's very awkward to have like this giant bike in the room, so I wanted to make it look kind of cozier by putting all plants around it at the window. So we have an ivy plant, and these plants were actually in the bedroom video just for decoration. They actually live in the office at the window because they need quite a considerable amount of light. And then this beautiful plant that I'm not gonna try to pronounce, but I'm gonna put the name of. She's so pretty. In a pot that I painted, I put his biking shoes into this basket. So everything just looks less, I don't know. It just doesn't look that bad to have a bike in the room anymore. And the bike is very important to him, so I want to have the bike in the room. Just make it look less awkward and cozier, and I think it does. So I've been working in this space for almost a week now and it feels really amazing. Honestly, the room feels super big, like so much bigger compared to before, and it just feels lighter and airier, and I love like all the colors, but at the same time it's still neutral and like calming because the walls are white. And I don't find his bike an eyesore anymore. So thank you for watching this video and I hope you liked our office slash mini art studio space.